So, today we are going to be doing a new video. We are going to find more ways to get more life out of our older devices, or as some people call them, legacy devices. So, I currently have an iPod Touch 2nd generation here. I am using the highest firmware that you could get with this, which is iOS 4.2.1. Also, I have just restored it, so everything is back to the way it used to be. And we are going to try out the all-new Whited00r 7 to give it an iOS 7 feed. There's two options you could do with Whited00r. You could try to find the old download links if you want iOS 6 look, but if you want the iOS 7 look, get the latest. So, let's go on to the Whited00r.
Okay, so you can see that my iPod is restored. I had to restore it again because I couldn't do this right the first time. So that was a pain. So we're going to be using iReb, and I'll just show you the screen, and there's instructions on iReb anyway, so if you don't understand, I will also walk you through it.
Okay, so we're here with our iReb, so I'm going to be doing my iPod Touch 2nd generation. So prepare to press the power and the home button. So you press them at the same exact time. I've already done this before multiple times, but this is just a better way to put it in DFU mode. Okay, so once it goes down to zero, you just start pressing the circle button. And so you hold it until it is finally put in the best way just to put it is DFU state. So it's pwn, DFU state, black screen, so it now will do nothing. That's what you want. That is perfect. So you're going to choose whichever, and so I've already downloaded it, so it was a pain to install, but I got it. Yes, okay. So, I have it here. So, this is what we need to install it with. So, we're going to open up iTunes. Close iRib. Restore, but we're going to do shift left click, right? Yep. No, right click, sorry. Yeah, wait. Yes, left click. Oh my god. So, I have it saved in my recording section, Whited00r, and we're going to restore it with the appropriate version of Whited00r. Now, while this is restoring, you have to be very careful on what you're doing here. So you can see I have a ton of these open. But basically what you're going to do is that if you have the MB version, you install here, and the MC currently is still in developer preview 1. It's going to be buggy like heck, so I wouldn't recommend it yet, because when Whited00r was on 4, 5, and then 6, there wasn't even an MC version. So this is the first time that they're trying to make it for the MC. Now, if you're wondering about later devices like the iPod Touch 3rd generation, iPhone 3GS, iPad 1st generation, Whited00r is not supporting those, but I know there's another project. If I open it up here, I don't know how far they've gotten. Redd00r. So, Redd00r will support these devices. The nice thing about the Redd00r project, which has not even created anything yet, which is disappointing, is that it's going to be based on iOS 4. When you're using Whited00r, you're using iOS 3.1.3. You are not using iOS 7. It gives you iOS 7 features. I know I haven't messed around with Whited00r 7 until now, so when I had Whited00r 6, there wasn't real multitasking, it was more like your previously opened apps. They also didn't have really good folders, because the folders were so glitchy. That's why I stuck with iOS 4.2.1. So I'm going to switch over to my iPod now.
So I have just installed Whited00r, and you're going to see that it doesn't look like iOS 7 right now. It gives you the original iOS 2 and 3 boot up, but you'll see that the icons look like iOS 7. Now, don't fear, it will look more like iOS 7, but what you have to do is you have to reboot it.
Also, I forgot to mention that this is an untethered jailbreak, so you'll never have to connect it to your computer when you turn it off and turn it on. But another thing you're going to want to do is that if you're going to connect it to the computer, it's going to say update. Do not update, or you're going to completely lose the jailbreak. So just ignore it, and that's all I can really say. Because if you guys remember, if you have one of these devices, you will remember. But the only way to get updates prior to iOS 5 was you had to connect it to the computer. So we're going to wait for this to turn on. Okay, here we go. Whited00r was here. That's funny, I've never seen it do that. Cool. Okay, so you're going to see that Whited00r is finally installed, but there is one more thing that we're going to do. So, you're going to notice that some features might not work properly. So what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to install Repo00r. It is a patch for Red00r and Whited00r users. I was mistaken when I said that Red00r hasn't made anything yet. They just made a couple firmwares, but they were so glitchy that they said wait for another update. So I guess we will all wait. But what they have so far is looking pretty cool. You can look them up on the Whited00r forums. Also to mention, Red00r and Whited00r have nothing to do with each other. So you're going to go to the App Market, which is not really the App Store. Well, it kills the mood, so I guess I'm going to restart it again. This happens every now and then. So, we'll be back once it's done. Okay, we're back. Now, another nice thing with Whited00r is that it has the same, you don't have to slide to unlock from the bottom. So, let's hope this worked now. Oh my god, don't tell me it's gonna do this. Huh. Settings. Interesting. So now that we're back in, this is what I was talking about. So there's a Red00r setting button. Now this is what I need to use the Repo00r patch for, but you can basically activate more features. So they have Sarah turned off, which is a fake Siri, folders turned off, and these things, and you can unlock more. So I'm going to let that do its thing, and I'm going to try to get... Oh yeah, here's your warning, just again. You're also going... I just don't know why I can't get the App Market open. So, like I said, there's three app stores inside there. There was the official one from Apple. Oh, finally, okay. There's App Time Machine, which is a program only for Whited00r. It allows you to get all the older version of apps that would work on Whited00r or iOS 3.1.3. Then we have, of course, the official app store, and then Cydia. So we're going to go into Cydia. Dismiss. Cydia. Sorry about the shaky quality. Don't have a very good camera for this. Done. We're going to go to manage. I'm going to let this load. Sources. As you can see, everything on this device has been themed for iOS 7. These guys really put some time into this. Edit. Add. Oh my god. www.repo.door.com. Now, with door, it is two zeros. Then you're going to say add source. So it's going to install it. And if you're new to Cydia, then don't be alarmed by any of this code. This is just an installing. Also to mention, I had just jailbroken my iPod Touch. It has never been jailbroken until about a few months ago. So I'm kind of new to this too, but I'm catching on. Now, another thing I noticed is that it kind of got stuck on the downloading packages and reloading data. If you think it's already been done for a while, what I do is I just press the circle button. Because this is done, but then it just sits there. So let's see if it's done. I know this isn't the best way to be using Cydia, but that's just kind of what I've had to do for a while. Loading. There. Repo00r. Patch. Install. Oh, confirm. There we go. It's just about done. Now it's going to say restart springboard. So it's basically restarting the springboard is just a faster way of turning off your device. You know, like on a computer, the restart button? That's basically what this is. Except it's way faster. Okay? There we go. Okay, so now we're going to go to settings. Now, the only reason why I installed Whited00r is because I couldn't do this. So, remember, in our Whited00r settings, I turned on advanced so I could basically get everything. So, you want to turn everything on that you want. Now, if you're using an iPod Touch and you want to use the fake Siri Sarah, you need to make sure that you're using headphones with a microphone, because the iPod Touches do not have a camera or a microphone. Just to confirm, on the back is only the Wi-Fi antenna, and that sounded bad. Okay, so if you want to go to, So you just scroll through. And so I'm going to turn everything on, like I said. It's so hard to do this, like, while recording. I really need a stand. That's what I need. Now, for the last page, this is very important that you make sure you know what you're doing here. Okay, so this is what you want to turn on or off. So if you're using an iPhone, you can turn off location services, cell services. You can even turn off the smooth animations. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn on a couple of these things. I'm not going to remove those. Dictionary mover, font mover. That should be good. And then once you're done, don't exit out. Just do apply changes. Now, the way to know if you need Whited00r is that this thing will just do this forever. I literally waited a half an hour without Whited00r, and it did absolutely nothing. That's why you're going to want to use Whited00r. Now we wait. Okay, we're back. It is finally finished. And so now we should get all the cool features. We have a control panel. We have all of our buttons, and everything works really well, actually. I was surprised that it worked so well. Now, a couple things to mention. There was no flashlight on this thing. So, what we used to use, if you guys remember, flashlight! Yeah, not very good memories, but they're memories. And then the Do Not Disturb button. Sorry, this function is currently not available. Got it. Everything else works. I do not believe that there's a drop down, and so if we can turn on Sarah. Oh, thanks for cooperating, Sarah. She must be in a bad mood or something. Okay, so I wanted to show you the app time machine, but for people who have been stuck on iOS 3 for a long time, know that there was no folders, but now you can make a folder. Yay! Now, folders are probably the buggiest thing in Whited00r. So you can kind of see that it's not like iOS 7, but, I mean, really, you should just be grateful you're getting a folder. So I'm going to call this, I don't want to put these two in a folder. So I'm going to try to get these to leave. So I'm going to throw in a couple stock apps. Now I notice that this is very glitchy when you're doing it like that. So I don't need terminal. And then I can just call these. You see, it doesn't really work the way you would want it to. Stock apps. Now if you press here, here is the first time that you're going to see yourself go into safe mode. Now safe mode is just a mode that lets it turn off anything that could harm the device. And so just imagine that the slide bar is still there, because that's the only way you can turn it on in safe mode. And so what you're going to want to do is, if you're really that concerned, don't worry. Just press restart. And it should just turn it back on. It will just restart the springboard. Now, what a problem I had is that I got stuck in safe mode. Every time I said restart, it went back into safe mode. So if that ever happens, probably your best bet is to restore again. That's all I can tell you. Now we're going to go into App Market. App Time Machine.
So there's a website that where you can basically give them your old IPAs for all your old apps, but first you have to have the IPA. And I don't know how you would obtain them, but I know there's a way. So let's just say I want to download social networking. Let's install Facebook. Here's the latest version. That will work on this at least. So it says download started. So we're going to go to downloads and you're going to wait. So it says right here. And so once it's done downloading, it will go down here and it will go through one of the spin wheels and then it'll tell you when it's done. Now, settings. You can delete IPA files, use UA catch on install. Nope, it's installing that now. There's a search bar. And then there's the home. It says how many downloads there's been, how many apps, and then that. Now, there isn't that many apps, so they're still trying to get more. Also, if you want Whited00r 6, there is also all of these things except for the iOS 7 theme. But I don't know if with Whited00r if there is. Oh, they took out newsstand. I just realized that. Well, no one really used it. Okay, so I forgot to mention. Good thing coming back. So, you here is your app switcher. So let's open up a ton of apps. Let's open this. That. So you're gonna go to your app switcher. So this is only showing the apps that you previously opened. These cannot be closed. And they're very buggy, so if you try to do this, you'll probably just put yourself in safe mode, which I just did. So, I don't recommend using that. It is much easier just to press the circle button than have to deal with this. Trust me. Now, another thing I'm going to show you is how to change your wallpaper. So, another nice thing about Whited00r is that you can finally change your wallpapers and have one. There was Winterboard, but I just don't like Winterboard. I feel it. Slow. Doesn't work that well. I don't know. My opinion, though. So you're going to go to brightness and wallpaper. Don't use iOS 3 wallpaper. That's just saying who made it. And so let's just change it to this one. Then do set. I'll do set both. Applying wallpaper. Okay. Now if I go here, it is now set with my new wallpaper. So, I think that concludes this episode on how to use Whited00r, how to install. And if you have any questions, don't forget to leave them in the comments. I should come around and answer most of them. And if you enjoyed, don't forget to leave a like, rate, and subscribe. Well, bye guys!